Here's what I posted. Okay, next slide. Step two, invite the community to participate. Don't tell them. This is not a broadcast channel, this is social media. And any consumer, male or particularly female, needs to be told what to do. Developing an invitation or a channel, identifying your authentic evangelists, and sharing the ownership of the community. Blogger would not be what it is without community members like my friend Bridger, who's here today, who has been, raise your hand, who's worked with an incredible number of brands and is a serious and important voice, right? So this is the confidence of the company that the community built, and so too can yours be, because a self-empowered user is someone who will advocate fight for you. Anyone would be an influencer, right? Now it's something different. Next slide. We're going to keep moving through this. You can read my posts. Really strong positive response from the community. Next slide. Form an advisory board and use it. Invite and incent a diverse advisory board. And when I say diverse, I don't just mean gender, right? If you're a women's company, you need men on your board and you need men on your team. My team is 40% men. I also mean diversity, yes, of race and ethnicity. My God, you know, it's 2015. But also of culture and of experience and of economic background. I mean, it's really important to think about the full spectrum of your user base and people who will keep you honest. You need your internal, if you ever heard the phrase, this is a favorite in an Irish household, it's not for Irish, someone who's a street angel and a house girl. This is someone who out on the street, she's got her Sunday best, she's good to go to church, you get her home, she throw that tantrum. Right? You really need your bears in-house. Now, step four, create a welcoming space for the community to show up and participate. There really needs to be recognition of your advocates. Yes, they're on an advisory board, but then they'll invite their people, and what if their people want to own and share what they see them doing. There is nothing like a badge. There is nothing like a hashtag. There is nothing like a gathering in person when appropriate on a regular basis. So the last thing I would just leave you with is the important message. I'm sure you all are aware that social media serves a purpose, not every social medium will serve your purpose. Use it appropriately. Some things cut across all media, others never should. So I'll give you a quick example. Facebook. Brilliant. Brilliant. For fun fashion. Not brilliant. Don't ever touch it for personal care. Okay? We just don't talk about those things in front of our pastor and apologize. Next slide. What matters? Our really erudite system, which you can kind of imitate by working with TweetReach or Hootsuite or some other much fancier tools like Spreadfast or Sprinklr. But our proprietary system really shows what's happening. Earned Facebook and Twitter engagement are above and beyond the expert shares that we had from our 240 people. And every once in a while we hit gold. What happened there was, next slide, a fashion blogger on Facebook shared a PRI story that she fell in love with, right? And you just went supernova. That absolutely can happen to you. Next slide. And we're not going to watch this now, but if you need proof that your everyday user will blow your mind with her brilliance, go watch what a group of women said to President Obama and to me on April 15th when we hosted the Obama Town Hall in Charlotte, North Carolina. Their concern.